Sure.
17 and a half. 17 and a half. Now, oh, could be 18, depending on how you count the dwarf woman. The dwarf woman. You were trying to figure out whether to count her as a full person, or the people hanging from the tree. Name's Adair. Though to the people around here, might as well be 19. Don't think I'd put you much higher than 22, 23 tops. Well, I was smoking over here, saw you staring at her. Twice I refilled my pipe. You never so much as blinked. Your mouth was so slack, I took you for a Radric at first. Careful, friend. Best not use that word round here. There'd be any number of Radric bootlickers within earshot. Of course, seeing you with that funny look, I'd be halfway inclined to believe you were having some kind of communion with that dwarf. Either case, maybe I'm not 19 after all. The town's had it in for me for a long time now. Only fellow who ever stuck up for me, well, he's number 18 up there. Picked the wrong god. That's what it comes down to. Used to be a lot of Vaethys worshippers in Gilded Vale. Then one day, somebody named Widewind shows up on Deerwood's doorstep. Says he's the living flesh of Vaethys. Got an army with him. Suddenly, Vaethys isn't so popular in these parts. My brother Woden and me, neither of us believed it. No way was that Vaethys. After the war, people took to punishing Vaethys worshippers, accusing them of treason. Got real ugly, especially after the legacy started. Folks needed someone to blame. I was safe because I fought, but then this rumor starts that my brother, that he was on the wrong side. And I wasn't so safe anymore. Not till my headman stepped in and said they'd have to hang him to get to me. Seems that's no longer a concern. Of course, the townies don't do the hanging these days, but when... blew him up. Seem to remember hearing something about that years ago. He tamed that place. People would seek him out for all kinds of things. Trouble a man such as that, there'd be things I'd want to ask him. Don't know why I never thought of it before. Not sure how I feel about setting out with a stranger, and a strange one at that. But, truth be told, you might be the only one in town who wouldn't feel some relief seeing me swing from that tree. All right, then. Guess I'll do some sightseeing. I haven't been in here for... but...
Eh? Got it. Why not? There, done.
curses!
Let's go! Huh?
Most inconvenient.
Keeping an eye out.
Quickly and quietly. Thank you.
It's strange looking back. All the time. It's strange looking back. All the time I spent here growing up. Never seeing what was coming.
No problem. Huh? This won't stop me for long. This won't stop me for long.
We got...
Of course.
For Anthus!
Yeah? Sure.
Let's go! These uns are in for blood! These uns are in for a walloping! Let's have it out! Let's have it out! Let's go! Let's go!
Damn it. We gotta take better care of Aloth. Hey.
Let's go!
Yeah? Yeah?
Let's go!
Problem. Got it.
Ah!
That's not very helpful.
Huh?
Remind me never to help kill my god again.
Why not? There, done. Yeah? Hmm?
Hey.
Hmm?
Candles are still burning. Not bad for a dead god. Redemption. They got this whole rite for when you come of age. They take you by the hand and you descend through the temple with your eyes covered, and that's supposed to be like a wicked life. They don't tell you where you're going. I was sweating like crazy when I did mine. They take you to that reflecting pool back there, and you're allowed to look at it so you can face your sins. Then, you come out into this room and you uncover your eyes again and everyone's there to greet you, all your friends and family. It's like you've been redeemed. The candles are still burning. Not bad for a dead god. It was nice to see those candles still burning. I figured they'd have gone out by now.
Hail, traveler.
Let's go!
Saw you in the flames. Come to pray at the statue. The others are welcome, but it's best if just you and I trade words, and your shadows stay quiet. I swear before the whore that is Margaret, no harm will come to you in her shadow. If that's enough of a promise for you. If not... The world holds many whores we worship. Respect comes with honest titles. But if I give offense, if words are all that are left to a man, then why in the Deerwood of all places he should have leave to speak them? I didn't give it. You probably find names as useless as I do. It's what's beneath the skin and the letters I care about. What burns within. It's more important to me you're a watcher than whatever culture or accent decorates your letters like awkward crowns. Take pride in your actions, not where you hail from, or how your name rolls off whatever liar's tongue coats it now. If you need a title to hang on me to match your own, watcher, then call me Durance. I am a missionary. I walk this disease nation with its heathen, its people so careless with the spirits of others and their own. We're meant to travel together, you and I. Saw you in the flames. Not your face, but that soul of yours. There's things we can teach each other. I don't force my words on anyone other than you. I don't care who walks with you or what their mewling problems and politics are. There's enough howling in the world without me stoking that fire. Many will stand against you. They probably already have, from what I can see. Disease? Spirit wind? Both could have touched you, yet here you stand. As for disease, not all of us were close to water when the pox hit. But it's no longer a passenger in my flesh. It left its marks as well. Her? Don't fear her jealousy. Let us see what the road holds, Watcher.
Hmm?
Thank you.
Let's go!
Yes.
Yeah?
Legions are in. That's it!
Let's go!
No problem.
What?
How may I help?
Thank you.
You cannot venture forth while in combat.
Good day to you.
How do you do?
Thank you.
Yeah?